Greetings, sir and sirettes, and welcome back to Ark Survival Evolved with me, Latherix, and welcome to Grim, my newest Argentavis, my newest melanistic Argentavis, in fact. Isn't that just a thing of absolute beauty? Pure black and grey. It's even the talons are black, which is kind of amazing. So, yeah, yesterday I was having a bit of an Ark... A bit of an Ark spree, honestly. People on Twitter will have had the fun of me spamming images and random waffling about the game, because I was just in one of those moods. But anyway, yesterday I went, as I say, I was having a spree, and I've done a bit of taming. Now, by a bit of taming, I mean... I've got a lot of new animals which I need to explain and show you. I've actually got a video of me taming one of them which I'll show you when I actually find it. So, anyway, I'm here right now farming obsidian. As you can probably tell, I'm mining obsidian exclusively because today, on our actual purpose, we are going to be making the assault rifle because we are getting ready for the broodmother fight. Now, people have been asking me, after you've done the broodmother, are you going to finish the game? And that is a big no. The game is obviously not finished just if you kill the Broodmother. All the Broodmother does really is give you a very pretty flag. Although the Broodmother is seen as the end game, there's a lot I still need to do. I need to build the memorial, I need to build a proper house, I need a farming system to get the better gear, and this is all because there are updates almost every day right now. There are new dinosaurs coming in very soon, another batch of them, and a big thing, the big dragon boss is rumoured to be coming by the end of next month, which means, of course, we need to be ready, because that's going to be higher, it's going to be stronger than the current Broodmother. Oh, look, a Rex. What level are you, Mr. Rexy? Level 81! Level 80! Well, okay, we need to keep an eye on that, apparently. Also, it's a male. I actually do need a male Rex, because of my two T-Rexes, are both female right now, so... Oh, no! Okay, well, let's get back, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. I actually have quite a bit of obsidian now. We need 120 obsidian, I figured out, so put that in there. So, currently we have 55, so we're almost halfway through our journey. There's a Rex there having a bit of a rave party. Somebody must have dropped the base nearby. So be right back when I get back to the base. Base, drop the base. Oh, funny. Home sweet home. Well, I guess it is home, but right now it is simply a crafting shed. The home will come very soon, because I have a new way of getting timber, as I'll show you in a minute. But still, right now, we have the forge, obviously. Let's put down the metal. We have nothing to burn. Do we have a single wood. Yay, possibly a couple more metal. So we'll let that burn right now, then we'll go to the top and we'll deposit the obsidian and see exactly what we need. Then I'll go and fix my pickaxe before we go out again, obviously. So, let's have a quick look, and we are looking at the weapons, firearms, and the assault rifle, which needs 60 polymer, which is 2 obsidian per one and 2 cementing paste. So straight away we have 120 cementing paste needed and 100 obsidian. Of course we have 120 obsidian, so right now we have 57, so it's almost halfway. After that, we need, what else do we need? And the metal's no issue. So really, it's going to be a lot of stone. It really is. Because obviously cementing paste is stone and keratin. Thankfully, I have a bunch of keratin. It's only going to be the stone, obviously, as before, which is the issue. Oh, look, we have 32 of us. I didn't even realise. Of course, because we're getting obsidian, aren't we? Well, that's good. At least we're getting some way towards it. Okay, is there any metal already in here? I'm going to have to transfer it. There already is metal. Fantastic. And you can't be repaired because you have exactly zero wood. Well, that's just annoying. Okay, well, let's go and look at the new animals. Then I'll grab the wood from the one which has about 500 in its inventory. So, let's start off with the closest to the base. You can probably already see there's been a bit of change. I had a bit of a gaming spree last night. People on Twitter probably were very annoyed by the kind of spam of images and constant waffle about the game, because I was in one of those moods where I was really into the game. So, first of all, we have Carneth, who I actually have a video of, which I'll show you before we leave. Yep, Carneth here was actually surprisingly easy to tame. It turns out Rexes on the easier difficulty to tame, since it's the first time taming one in that, are actually okay because they don't lose their knockout stat very fast, and they have such a high knockout stat. There we are, 5,400, the Torpor. That if you use Prime Meat, which I was, it's actually quite quick. You'll even see in the video I actually give it a bit of Prime Meat and it goes up by loads. Secondly, we have these four unnamed beauties. We have 3 male, 1 female Sabertooths. Now, the reason why they're unnamed is because I actually kind of really, really suck at naming them. Oop. A Dilo attacked the group. Oh, Pete's egg. Yeah, I suck at naming them, so feel free to name them in the comments below, sir and such. We have the female pack leader here, and then her three, I guess you would say, consorts, all male. So that's my little group of Sabertooths. It turns out, with the Sabertooth, the low-level ones at least, if you are using prime meat, which of course you always are if you're flying around in Argentavis, able to kill pretty much anything because of their speed, they don't even need a single narcotic once they're knocked out, which is rather nice. Okay, last but certainly not least, excuse me, other than the dodo, ignore the dodo, that was just a bit of fun. You two, come with me, because one of you is it. Meet Titan, my level 122 mammoth. Yep. That happened. I found a level 90-something mammoth. I tamed it. It's really quite simple. Thankfully, the Bronto getting berries was exceedingly easy. Now, I learned something from Little Titan here. And that is, if you are higher level by default, by your wild level, you actually get more experience, sorry, more stat, when you level up from the player. In that, the best example is just these two compared. By the way, they're actually mate boosted now. Yay. And I stole your saddle. I'm sorry, Timber. But Timber here gets about 100 to 200 health per level at most. Titan gets almost 500 health per level, if I choose to level health. Meaning that although I've only leveled Titan once, Titan's almost at 5,000 health already. Meaning that but by the time I've leveled it maybe 10 times, it's going to maybe have 10,000 health. This thing is going to be my mount in the battle against the Broodmother. Okay, so that is pretty much that. That is the whole lot I managed to tame. I was after a high-level raptor as well, but I could only find level 31, which is over there if you manage to see them, called Chow. So what I'm going to do, obviously, I want to get some wood from the pet I literally just had the inventory open of. Hello, Torch. Why are you all the way over here feeling all neglected? Oh, that's really sad. All the groups over here, look. So where is that little bugger? There you are, Chow. Hello, Chow. Basically, I just got it for the mate bonus, because if I'm going to be on a raptor, I may as well have two raptors, because they're quite easy to have like that. So let's get some wood. Now, I'll get two stacks, because I also need to burn some for the metal. So I'll go and repair my pickaxe, and then I'll go back to getting obsidian. Be right back. Oh! You can see the video of me grabbing Carnef. Well, feeding Carnef some prime meat. Seriously, it's actually surprisingly easy. So there, but I'm still a bit nervous about going after that level 81, but I'm almost certain I'm going to. For two reasons. One, these are both female, so they need the male mate bonus. And two, it's a level 81 Rex. Can you imagine how powerful that's going to be with the extra levels and stuff? So, be right back. Enjoy the mini video. Well, a very small change of pace, sir and sirettes. I've just been attacked by, and now want to tame, a little Sabertooth I've just saw. However, I do believe that this Argentavis may be fighting it. Oh, there's two of them. Well, let's let them fight. Or should I, because then they might be able to die. I think they're quite low level, the Sabers are. Not sure if they actually hit or not. Okay, well, they killed the Avis. There we go, nice arrow in you, and in your face, and I'll let that take its effect. And then for you, we miss. Or five, good, oh good, the one, oh they're both female, excellent. That's exactly what I wanted to see. That went into the rock. I don't really want to kill them, that's the problem, so I'm letting the arrows actually take effect. That's what I'm trying to say there about stammering. Because, oh they're both male, darn it, I thought they were both female, never mind. Then it's the opposite of what I want, but they're still quite low level, which means I'll be quite easy to tame. There goes one. What level are you? I thought you were both. There we are, both of them go down. Fantastic. Get here, Grim. Grim has at least one prime meat on him right now, so. Inventory first? Nah, whatever. Probably got way too many claws. Wait, you did have at least one prime meat on you. It must have rotted. Even when they're being held by a creature, it takes forever. Oh, I'm actually harvesting the stone behind it at the same time. That's quite impressive, got to be said. There we are, eat the meat. Keep on going. Okay, two raw prime meat. We'll give those to the sabers. One for you, and one for you. So far, from what I've seen, honestly, with the sabers, it does seem like they're the ultimate pack animal in this game. The ultimate hunting pack kind of animal. That's not necessarily accurate to real life. Even the dossier says, well, that's a bit odd. But then kind of attributes it to the whatchamacallit. To the fact, you know, they're in a weird island with rexes and everything. Like, in close quarters all the time, so I've kind of adapted to that. There we are. And now, to prove a point, we don't need to use narcotics. I'll put them in the inventory just in case, but I'm certain we can get both of these without the use of narcotics, and they're so fast, it's very easy to cart them back to the base once I'm done. Okay, so how much obsidian have I got so far? Got another 40, that was metal. You get so much metal doing this. We've got another 30, so we still need... That's 5, 6, 7, 8. So we still need another 40. Okay then, back to farming. I guess I'll just stick around here and try to kill some... Well, creatures that'll drop prime meat. There's a Stegosaurus just there, so I guess I'll go and kill that. That'll give me some more prime meat for the sabers. Then I'll go back to farming obsidian. That sounds like a good idea, doesn't it, Sonsrets? Of course it does. I wonder if I hit the parasaur. Apparently, yes. Can we kill both at the same time? Come on. Oh, no, the parasaur. Sadly, Grim hasn't been leveled much yet, and its damage is pretty much just the default damage. So as you can see, it's a fair bit slower than regular. Now, I'm not going to use my pickaxe, although it'd be a bit faster, purely because two reasons. One, I want the experience for the Argentavis. Two, my pickaxe is almost broken. I still need another 40 obsidian. Any more prime meat? It'd be lovely if you gave me at least more than... just one, really? That kinda sucks. Well, thankfully there are some mammoths around and stuff. What I'd love to see is a Bronto just come walking by. Oh, that Argentavis is getting way too close to the sabers. Actually, let's see. The Ivis doesn't actually go for it. Well, sadly, it will go for me, however, when I get down there, so I might as well attack it first. Come on, you also drop prime meat. So there's multiple reasons why you need to die, I'm afraid. I am the bringer of death. Just look at my new flying mount. It's a melanistic Argentavis. What more could you want? To prove pure evil intent. Ah, I do need one of you guys. I can't tame you right now because my Bronto's too far away to get berries, but I do still need an ankler. Aw, I miss my little ankle. Really? No? What's with the bad luck with prime meat at the moment? Well, at least we got one. I mean, could have been worse, could have got none. But still! I've had, like, Argentavis kills where it's dropped, like, loads of prime meat. Like, two or three in one kill. Come on, can one of you please eat so I can see how much you actually use? Do narcotics increase food consumption? No, only the berries do. Okay. Well, lesson learned there. And a waste of a narcotic, sadly. I might force feed them narco berries, just because, well, get some stone. I mean, that's not bad, since I actually do need stone for my stuff. Come on, can I have just one narco, thank you. Just because I'm probably not going to get any bonus levels out of these guys anyway, because of how low level they are, so it does increase food consumption, okay. So if I could perhaps force feed them some berries just to speed up the process. Come on, eat a single, please just eat one of the meat. I think I eat it when they're like 50. Wait, no, that's not 50 down. Oh, does it actually fill more food? I didn't know that. I didn't know that prime meat also filled more food. I thought it was just a matter of gave more for its thing. Oh, that actually makes prime meat a little bit worse than I thought it was. Well, might as well gather some stones. I'm going to need hundreds upon hundreds of darn things because I'm going to need 8 stone per cementing paste, and I need 100. Oh my lord, I'm going to need like 1,000 stone. That just dawned on me. Okay, I'll wait until they eat a single meat, then I'll leave. Just making sure I can definitely tame them without any more narcotics. Okay, well, finally, it has indeed ate the prime meat. And as you can see, this is the higher level. Actually, they're both 5. Oh, never mind, they're both level 5. So as you can see, this will indeed get there without the use of narcotics, as long as I get some more prime meat. Of course, I do still have the 2 narcotics for that one, and I still have the... Oh wait, I think I have 1 narcotic for the other still. So, I am back on the hunt for prime meat. I'll be right back once these guys are tamed. As really all I'm going to do is go and find a mammoth, kill a mammoth, get the prime meat hopefully, feed them again. It'll, by the looks of it, they'll either need 3 or 4 prime meat each, so it's not too much. It's just a little bit annoying I've been unlucky, because off camera just then I actually killed 2 more stegos and got none. So, yeah. On the upside, my little Grim here is getting a lot of experience killing mammoths. Come on, die. Give me your meat. You see, now, if you give me prime meat, it means that your friends and family don't need to die as well. And again, I really should use my pickaxe here, or, well, yay, a single prime meat. But I don't want to break it, because I don't want to go back and repair it. And I do at least have narcotics with me, and I could always just get some narco berries if that is needed. Oh, fantastic, 3 raw prime meat already. So that'll be enough for one of them. And almost enough for... Oh, 4! Fantastic! That means they've both got 3 prime meat. That's absolutely wonderful. Okay, let's go and put it in their inventory and carry on. Then we'll have 2... So basically, certain sets, this is all you missed off-camera. Literally me doing this for various kinds of carnivores. And then there's one herbivore, which is even more boring, because it was just the Bronto. You know, the Bronto simply stood there, grabbed berries. I just fed it like 500 berries at a time and just kind of waited for it to be tamed. I find that at least with carnivores, you've got to do a bit of hunting or something while you're nearby. With a Bronto, it's so easy to tame herbivores, it's not even funny. Oh no, you've ate a single one of your meat. That's actually a bad thing, because that means his hunger's gone up. Okay, so be right back when they're tamed anyway. Sadly, while I was gone, the saber-tooths were attacked by a raptor. You can see it dead over there. So, yeah, I've lost one of my 2 saber-tooths, but the other one is just about to be tamed, thank the Lord. So, it turns out, I definitely didn't need any more prime meat. Although I've gave them some more, they could just eat the raw meat at this stage and be tamed. So, you definitely don't need narcotics for the lower level saber-tooths. Yay! Even though I did use 2, that only accounts for a little bit of torpor, and look how much, we still have another 200 left. There is, however, something of interest, a red supply drop over there. So what I'm going to do is wait until this thing eats the last meat. I've leveled up Grim a little bit more, killing mammoths, yay. And then we'll go back to farming obsidian over there, because I've kind of mined out all this area anyway. So be right back with that. At last, the Sabertooth lives, well, obeys anyway. Come on, lad, let's go. So thankfully with Sabertooths, they don't really get stuck on anything. They can actually, but if you watch, they basically climb over things. As you can see, most rocks they seem to climb over, and if not, they are actually a lot better than most animals at dealing with obstacles, so it's actually okay to have them following along a bird. Unlike, let's say, oh, I don't know, a raptor or a mammoth or anything else. So that is certainly one point towards Sabertooths. I'm not actually a massive fan of them, weirdly enough. I have quite a few of them now, but I'm not a huge fan of them. I certainly respect how much damage they do. They're like one of the scariest things you could possibly encounter early game. But even then, as you can see, happily killing that. But I certainly respect them for the damage they deal and when they work in a pack, because they're so far the only group I've ever used which haven't got stuck on things, and they can basically climb up a lot of vertical objects, so they very, very rarely need your assistance. Which, that's my big problem with that huge Dilo swarm I had. It's like every time I went somewhere, I had to make sure they weren't getting jammed on things, and most lucky they were. Hello, Mr. Raptor. Yoink. Wait, is my saber attacking it while I'm holding it? I can't quite get it to face... There we go. It is. That's amazing. I didn't even know that happened. Okay, back to finding the thing if it's still there. Oh, oh yes, good. I thought I'd missed it then. If we're lucky, we'll get something pre-built, like a nice piece of armor. If we're unlucky, we'll get a recipe for something we don't need of the same quality we already have. Kill that raptor. There we go. Those couple of dilos. Let's deal with those. Because right now the saber's probably still quite hurt from being tamed, so I can't really have it solo things so much. Although it kind of just did anyway. I'm currently poisoned, so that's just fun. Yay! Red, what do you bring me today? Please be armor. I really, really, really would love if it's armor. Please! It's okay. I haven't had one before, so it's cool. I just probably will never make it because how expensive it is. It's like the grenades. I know how to make grenades. I've just never made one before because they're ridiculously expensive. Although I've been told a million times, laughter, because they basically like one-shot almost everything, which is awesome. And I'll probably try and make at least one before the Broodmother, but... Ooh, look at those sabers over there. Am I going... This has become a bit like a saber run, hasn't it? But saying that, as soon as I've got the obsidian, I'm just going to be farming stone, so... Yeah, don't think I can really deal with that many at once. First of all, I would be killed. Second of all, I just don't have enough meat or time for this. Okay, I can see one obsidian over there. Okay, let's help out. If we attack like this, we'll attack everything, including the stego, which means we'll get the stego kill as well. There we go. I'll harvest you. Then that's the enemy saber. The question is, where's my saber gone? Wow, first I'm getting stuck. Where is it then? There we are. What's wrong with you, lad? Ah, a rock a bit too steep for you, okay. How come every time I say something in this game, it instantly gets contradicted? These almost never get stuck on rocks, get stuck on a rock. Like, really, why all the time does this happen to me? Any reason why you're not helping? Go, Saber! Kill it! Get the kill! Go on! Ah, had a girl. Boy, had a boy. Okay, back to obsidian mining, I suppose. Well, I think that may be just about enough. I've almost broke my pickaxe again, because it turns out obsidian actually breaks your pickaxe faster than regular metal. And I've pretty much harvested this entire mountain, including this lovely core. As you may see, there's very little obsidian left, which is kind of a shame, because this is actually a very, very pretty place. I am tempted to build a base here one day, but... Right now, our attention must be put on getting things for the Broodmother and the memorial, which I'm going to be building soon. And I already have a nice place for it. Now, I left my my saber just down there. I don't think it's where the Argent Avis is. No, it's just nearby there. So I'll just go and grab him, and because I put him in quite a safe place. He was able to actually scale all the way up to about here-ish. About here-ish. Then he sadly couldn't make it any further up because it had basically gone completely vertical. So I'll just grab him and get back to the base, which is all the way... Oh, Lord, they're so far away and I'm so overburdened. I would say, you know what, I'll just throw away the stone. But for once, I really freaking need it. I could do start throwing away some of the food and stuff, try to get back to a regular speed. That would be nice. Okay, well, back in a second. I'll go meet up with my saber and then we'll get back to the base. And we return, and yet another consort for our female pack leader. That's getting very, very odd over there. I really do need to start finding some more female sabertooths, because, like I say, the reason why I'm collecting them is because I want their damage against the Broodmother, which I think I mentioned like about a million times now. So I really do need them to have that that mate bonus as much as possible. Okay, so let's put you here. Now stay, don't go too far away, not please. Oh god, don't bug out into me. This is why just jumping off is a bad idea, Sonserets. But sadly, the landing thing can bug out just as much. There we go. Please stop walking. I need everything you've got in your inventory. So let's just take one at a time. So we take the obsidian, we put it upstairs, and we can check how much you've actually got. Wow, that's still burning. That's quite impressive. That's it. Actually, you can put out the fire now. You're not actually doing anything. Just checking a few things. Okay. So that's what I was doing. Let's see how much obsidian I've actually got, and then if we add them both together. I'm hoping we get the 120, because I don't really want to go out for more obsidian now. As I put in here, so I did, I've got... Oh, I've definitely got it then. There we go. And click, that means we now have, yeah, far in excess. So how much did we need again? We needed weapons, firearms. We need 60 polymer, which means we definitely need 120, correct? Yes, we need 120. We've got 127. Fantastic. Why did I not put my cementing paste in here? I have some cementing paste already in the mortar and pestle, actually. Let's get the stone. We'll start that off as well. We're not too far off now, Sir and Stress. All we really need is stone. That is literally the only thing we're lacking, because I have hundreds of keratin from hunting on the Spino. The Spino is currently holding, I think, about 300 keratin. So it really just comes down to now, we need to go and pick up stone from the shoreline, which I think I'll skip the entirety of because you've all seen it 1 million times. There's 12 more, so I've already got 21 there. So we need 120 cementing paste for the polymer. Then we need 50 more, is it 60 more, for the actual gun itself. So firearms, we need 50 more for that as well. Okay. Is it just me who thinks that's a little bit too much? Just, that is such a boring thing to do. It's not like it's an interesting thing. Because, you know, getting obsidian, although it's not the most fun in the world, you know, you've got to go out there, you've got to actually do something for it. With the cementing paste, it's just, go and get stone. Which is remarkably dull indeed. Thankfully, where we just came from actually has a ton of stone. I think it's the first time I'm ever going to go away from the shoreline to actually get stone. But where we came from, yeah, there's loads upon loads of stone on the floor. Most of them being in the form of multiple harvest loose stones. Basically, the ones you can pick up from the floor, but you can pick up more than one stone, so you can do it more than once from there. So I'm just going to go all the way back over there, we're going to grab the stone, and we'll come right back. So, okay, let's just do the math. So we need 120 for the thing itself, so 120 times 8. Yeah, we're going to need over 1,000 stone. Well, this is going to be like 10 trips. Being the smarty pants I am, I decided to actually bring all of my Argentavis because, well, they can all carry a hell of a lot of stones. So anyway, this is what I'm talking about, these kind of stones. Because as you can see, you can actually pick them up multiple times. So am I, like, breaking bits off or something? So it actually shouldn't take too long. As you can see, although I need 1,000, I'm already at 10. So I'm already 1/100th of the way. I'm at 1% already. So it won't take too long, really, at all. And if I have all the Argentavis, let's do a bit of math. So a single stone, look, I have keratin on this one as well, oh god, hope. So a single stone is half of a weight. We can carry 300 each, a bit health for you. Yeah, okay, that one carry 350, this one carry probably a little bit less, it's a lower level. Hello, Torch. In fact, let's level it up a little bit. We should be able to do this perhaps in two trips, maybe one trip. I know that Grim has a higher capacity than the others because it was just naturally a higher level. If I drop all the other silly stuff, yeah, I might be able to do it in one trip then, since 300, so it's 600 in each if I drop everything else. So yeah, I should be able to, if I completely fill them all up with stone, I should be able to do this in one trip, and that'll, well, cut down on time quite a bit. So, honestly, Sir and Threads, be right back, you don't need to watch this. Well, we're finally returning home. I've got around about 800 stone, I think, which of course is nowhere near how much we actually need, because remember, after the initial 1,000, we're going to need even more, because, well, we need the 50 for the gun itself, the 50 paste, so 50 times 8 for the gun itself, another 400. So we're not really there yet. I just want to start off the production of the stuff, because obviously it's going to take a while to actually produce the paste. I've also made some more mortar and pestles, because it turns out they are literally just stone and hide. You can see it on my inventory there, if I just hold it down, it's 65 stone and 15 hide, so obviously I was able to make a couple of those as well. I think I've got 3 in, I think Hope's holding them. I'm thinking it's Hope, because how far behind she is. Oh, poor thing. Sorry, he is. We're all male. I've got a group of just males. My lord, we need to start getting all the genders together because, well, we're getting very close to needing the mate bonus more than ever with all the fighting and stuff. So, let's get back and let's put down the pestles and stuff. We return home, and sadly, it just dawned on me on the way in that I may have left the fabricator running again. So I think I've used up a little bit of gasoline. I don't think Torch actually has any stone on her. Do I have any Torch on stone? Or I can't remember, was it Grim? Oh no, Torch is holding some stone, so her landing there could be a little bit problematic. Sorry, he. He landing. I always think of Argentavis as female. I don't know why I do. But maybe because they're like elegant, because they're birds. It makes me think of, you know, a bit more feminine. I don't know. I really don't know. Got a lot of metal at least, and I think it might be raining. Nope, it's not raining. That's the sound of the fabricator running. I'll turn it off in a second. Thankfully, you only use one gasoline per 15 minutes, so really, we've lost almost nothing. Do I want them all facing the same way? Yeah, okay. What? What just happened? What just happened? It's in my inventory again as well. Oh, okay, well, at least we didn't lose it, but I'm not 100% sure why. Was it perhaps obscured but didn't tell me? No idea why that's happened. Doesn't really matter too much. You know what? They're all going to go different ways. This is so weird. Why does it sometimes just break on me? It's saying it's fine to place. Then I place it and it explodes. Well, okay, that's fantastic. Well done, you. So, let's see. Where's the one with actual keratin instilled? Sorry, keratin, rather. Okay, you... Okay, it's only 4 per one. I definitely have enough keratin then. So we're making 12 more. Then... okay, there we go. Let's turn off the thingy-majig. And off... I've still got 34 gasoline left. We're doing just fine. And we already have 10 polymer. Yay! How much are we going to need? We're going to need... 60 polymer. My lord. This is going to take so long. I think I'm just going to stay around this area now, though. We're not too far off in terms of how much stone we have. I don't mind being overburdened as long as I can still walk. I don't necessarily need to jump. Also, let me just grab the keratin off Grim, then I'll grab the keratin from the animals downstairs afterwards. Really? I've already grabbed all of yours? Hope, do you have any keratin on you? No, I dropped it all, didn't I? I forgot to pick it. Yeah, I dropped all of Hope's inventory to make way for more stone. Yeah, fun, right? So much fun, though. Okay, so I'll be right back once I've got all the keratin filled in. Once I've filled all these in with at least 100 keratin each. Well, the good news is that my lovely, lovely Spino had over 300 keratin on her just by herself. On the bad side, I'm not sure if I've actually got enough, even with that. I haven't harvested all of my pets. I haven't looted all of them yet. I looted a couple of them. And I've already put them in here. I'm just coming back now to start putting some more stone in to get production running on these ones as well. But I'm not 100% sure if I actually have enough keratin. If I don't have enough keratin, that means I'm going to have to go out. And I'm going to have to actually do some harvesting of things like trikes and such. But let's just grab this cementing paste and let's get started on the production of the polymer. Got 40 more there, so pop these in, turn this on, polymer is go. And I still haven't, of course I haven't grabbed all the stone yet, because sadly I can only grab 200 stone at once without being too overburdened. So let's grab all the stone from you, and let's grab a little bit more from Hope. Sorry, from Torch. By the way, Sir and Threads, just in case you're wondering, I have now been playing for over 5 hours for this episode. Just putting out there, this may be the longest recording I've ever done for one episode. And it's almost been completely harvesting material. Oh, the joy. Just put it all in here. There we are. So another 11 here. We have how much from you? We have another 10 from you already. You haven't really been doing much just yet. Need to put more stone in you. You have another 8. Okay, well, we're getting there. We're getting there. Like I say, we didn't get enough stone anyway. We're going to need to go back out. I know that. I'm just hoping I've got enough keratin, which I'm very starting to doubt, which is a shame. I didn't grab all the keratin from my lovely Spino either, so maybe he's got a little bit more left. Let's just leave all the birds up here. And let's just check. So, I have done a little bit of hunting on Carnef, but not much. I've done a little bit on Redemption, but again, not much. Let's see. How much do you have, if any? You have 7. Well, that's enough for almost 2 more. And Redemption, you have 2. That kind of is crap. Ooh. Thanks for pooping on my head there. Very, very kind of you, Carnef. Persephone won't have any, unless I've for some reason put it in there. Yeah, as you can see, I've been doing a lot of harvesting with this lovely lady. What I've been doing is collecting the wood and the thatch and then dropping off the... well, looting everything from her, like the thatch and stuff, and then dropping everything else. Ah, damn, I've already grabbed all the big stacks off the Spino. I don't think the two raptors have much, if any. Okay, so for those wondering how you get keratin, it's simply looting, well, simply harvesting animals such as trikes, what they're called, well, actually, yes, Spinosauruses, Stegosauruses, anything which you think has horns or spines, it will drop keratin. The one which drops quite a bit, actually, is the Ankylos. The lovely fellows with the spiky backs, because, well, the spiky backs are keratin. So you get quite a bit of that if you use your axe, and there's the problem. If you just harvest them with an animal, you don't actually get that much. At least, not as much in comparison. I need to put some more food in these guys. Since I basically took it all out just to make more room for stone. Here, have a single... there you go, Hope, you get 2 meat. You don't even need one. That's just a testament. So if you just leave them alone, they don't eat much. Let's do this. You know, I think I do have enough keratin. Just because I've got another 22 here. Yeah, I'm going to say I do have enough keratin, thankfully. At least I think I do. Did I just take the stone out of the Actually, what I could do is grab that stone and put it in with the other one, which has a little bit of stone, and then mix them together to make a single cementing paste. Do you have any more cementing paste for me? Nope. Okay, then. Well, 24 more. It's quite a bit. I'll say I need 120 for the polymer, then I need only 50 for the other one. So we've already got enough, let's say, for the main bit, just haven't got enough for the polymer yet. Actually, we're very close, though. Look at that. We're already on 45 polymer, which means we're almost there. We have a 12 there, so yeah, we've basically made enough for the polymer. We just need another 50 cementing paste. So I would say, yeah, we do have enough keratin, because it's only 40 for 10 paste. Okay, so all my lovely birdies, please follow me. We're going to go stone mining again, but this time I'm just going to go along the beach here, because I can't be bothered to go all the way back. And as you can see, there's plenty of stone here as well, just not quite as much. Well, I think this might have been the last stone run, and I'm certainly hoping so. Also, I'm dehydrated, yay. Random side note, I really hate this. If you're looting stone from the floor, let's say, and you've got not a full stack, and you decide to put it in your animal's inventory, you know, to make sure you can still walk around, etc., it doesn't stack properly unless it adds up to 100 or under 100, and that's really annoying to me. Random little gripe, really, really small gripe that really isn't too important at all, but just randomly annoying to me. It's just one of those little things. Okay, well, let's sort this out, shall we? We've almost got enough now for polymer. We almost had enough for the polymer already, rather. So let's put these in, sort out the rest of the paste, and then we are done. We don't have keratin there. Haha, that's why I got the extra keratin from before. But I didn't add it 20 because there's still a keratin left. You still have over 100 keratin. That's fantastic. Here's some stone. Make some more cementing paste. I'll take your cementing paste. Your cementing paste I'll take as well. Blah, blah, blah. You get the idea. And I didn't start you guys. Excellent. Got another 100 there, which is fantastic because 100 keratin is more than 40 paste. So that's fine. So how many do we have? We now have... Okay, so I need 3 more of those. So... 1, 2, 3. So now we just need to stack up 50 more cementing paste and we are done. So I think we do actually have enough. We are currently dying of thirst, but I don't really care too much right now because I just want to get everything sorted out. Finally, everything's almost sorted out. So 100 of these is equal to about 10. We've already got 10 in there. Oh, I think I might need a little bit more stone. Not much though, but little. I have no idea how I'm going to edit this video down to about 40 minutes or less. It's such a long thing. Ah, oh, it's been so long. There's another 24 straight away. So we've got 24. We've just made another 8. And we can take that stone away as well and put it in another one. So put it in here, because this actually has enough here. Ooh, got another 7 here as well. Fantastic. So we're getting 25 in this one, so that'll be 30. So we just need... No, sorry, that'd be 40. Yeah, 25 plus 15 equals 40. Which means we just need 10 to be in it. Oh, we have already. Thank the Dark Lord. Which means, I think, indeed, we... Yeah, we definitely have enough paste. Oh, I can just rest here and slowly die of thirst. Be right back, Sansarets. There we have it. The last cementing paste. I have all the metal from the forge in my inventory. We slowly ascend the stairs and turn to the fabricator and curse it for needing so much freaking stone. But then we rejoice because we actually have all the stuff we need to make the assault rifle. Turn on. Assault rifle, please. Thank you. Okay, so how do I make the ammo then? So the advanced rifle bullet simply needs gunpowder, that's fine. We actually made a couple before, didn't we, to test out. That's fantastic, we'll take that. Okay, so. Come on. La 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 la. We have an assault rifle! Wow, that looks cool as hell. So that's a standard scope, then of course we can put scopes on it and stuff. I feel like this might be the kind of gun which... Actually, I don't know how fast it does fire. But this is the kind of gun which would be okay with the... just the regular scopes and such. How do you actually take off a scope without adding another scope to it? So that's the flashlight, so let's put... Wait, can I not put the regular scope on this thing? Oh, I can't put... I just tried to put the regular scope attachment on it, it won't actually attach. Okay, that's interesting. Can I add the flashlight? Or the laser? Okay, so I can definitely add the laser attachment, so I imagine obviously can't have both of them at once. But still, I think the laser attachment might be the better for this. Wait, I did... There we go. Cool! It's on the top, I didn't realise. So we currently only have 2 shots in this thing. I don't think I've got the resources to actually make any more gunpowder. I've got the... If I've got some spark powder, then maybe I can. Oh, I do. So I have it in my inventory the entire time. I'm literally going to have to look back at the video just to see if I actually had that in my inventory the entire darn time. I want more than two shots, because if I'm going to test this thing, I want at least a couple of shots. So charcoal goes in, spark powder goes in, gunpowder gets made nice and quickly, and crafting. So we make two per time, don't we, with these? Okay. Let's reload the gun. So let's go and find something like a dodo or a dialode or something to shoot six shots at. Now, I really don't know how strong this gun is, I'll be perfectly honest. I haven't googled the strength of it. I normally kind of do, but this time I didn't. Okay, what level are you, Fiomia? 57. Nope, that's got way too much health for me to test on. I'd like something with, like, lowish health, honestly, just to see if I can... Because I know how much health a Dilo normally has at low levels. I know how much health all that sort of stuff normally does. Let's go hunting for one of those. Then we'll go and kill it, most likely. Oh, yay! Grim leveled up. Hello, little Dilo. Okay, then, let's test out our gun. Turn on laser sight, because... Oh, Pete's at Grim. Really good to land right there. Please don't aggro on Grim. One, miss, two. Oh. That wasn't too bad, honestly. It's a bit stronger than I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to be, well, I'm fairly certain it is weaker than the long neck rifle per shot, but it's the amount of shots you can actually put out. So let's just see how fast you can actually shoot this thing. This thing will definitely not die from these shots, but let's just test. Oh, wow. That was very quick. Da-da-da, and it's gone. Well, we're going to need to farm some serious gunpowder. So what I'm going to need to do off camera is go and get an ankler, and then that way I can start... I think it's an ankler, isn't it? The one I called ankle. Then that way I can mass farm things like flint and stone and stuff in that way. Because honestly, gunpowder isn't too bad when you have the animal for it. It's because you can mass farm flint. Because that was always the issue in the past, and thankfully the ankler gets flint from everything, so obviously I just need one of those, and that wouldn't be too hard to tame, because it's a herbivore, and herbivores are really easy, because you can just bring the Bronto. So I'll do that off-camera. Then next time, so and sets, we're going to do something a bit more fun. We're going to be focusing on building and getting some levels from animals. So thank you so much for watching. If you have enjoyed this probably quite long video, I'll try to keep it around about 40 minutes, but it has been like 5 hours now. So, if you have enjoyed this video and are enjoying ARK as a series, and of course, likes, favourites, shares, comments, all that good stuff helps out me, helps out the channel, and most importantly, shows that ARK is a series you wish to see continued in the future. Thank you, and goodbye. Please do take care.